fun. Of inspiration is at the heart of all creation.
Spark a dream that we're meant to follow.
You're listening to the Extra Magic Hour, brought to you by Walt's Apartment Podcast and the DisInsider. Join the team in the studio as they bring you the spirit of Disney through park news, history, and tips and tricks to make your Disney Parks vacation even more magical.
Hey, everybody. Man, I really like that those shows' intros mixed in together. Especially the Paint the Night and all that stuff. But anyways, what's going on? Welcome to Extra Magic Hour. This is the Walt's Apartment, Disney Parks, and Cruise Line centric show and everything in between. I am one of your hosts, Joey, and I am joined by the Cruise Master Sisters Superior, Courtney and Kelly. How are you ladies doing today?
We're doing good. Hi.
Yeah, doing good. Just got home from work.
Nice. That seems usual. To be the trending thing right now as we do. It's our double dip Wednesday, or for some of us, at least. Sam is en route, so she might be joining us shortly. But I just want to remind you guys that we are brought to you by some very awesome sponsors. Getaway Today, We're in the Park, and Sunken City Design. We'll hear about them later on in the show. But we got some fun Disney Parks topics to bring up to you guys this evening. Since Sam is not here, I will do her normal Today in Disney History. So, on this day, and as of we're recording, it is May 22nd, the Disney cartoon featuring Pluto, the Army mascot, premiered. And this was a very hungry Pluto schemes to become the Army mascot at Camp Drafty after seeing the tasty chow that the other animals are eating. This was one of the wartime era cartoons that Disney did during the what they call the war effort. And just to get everybody just to help out on the effort on the home. So I believe we see some of this at the Family Museum in the war area. So I do have the steel DVD set of the wartime stuff, which is some of those cartoons are pretty awesome. So have any of you seen that particular cartoon?
No, I don't think so.
I don't think so.
Okay.
And if I have, I was gonna say if I have, it was like during the time where I was like recording the late night like Ink and Paint Club, like that would show at 5 o'clock in the morning, and I don't remember.
Yeah,
they show that or not. So,
yeah, I think they pretty much kept a lot of the war cartoons off those ones, I believe, but I am not sure. But also on this day, May 22nd, 2015, Magic Kingdom premiered The Coolest Summer Ever. It's the unofficial kickoff to summer that took place around the resort. They had a 24-hour party, a special events that started as early as 6 a.m. and went all the way until a Saturday. So this was their, like, I guess, 24-hour day with Olaf being the main mascot throughout this event. So
was that the first one ever?
Let me see. So according to this site that I'm reading, guests can experience special appearances of the welcome show with Anna, Elsa, Kristoff. Olaf welcome everybody into the park. Oh,
no, it's not the first one because we went to 2014.
Well, this was at Disney World.
Oh, okay.
So this might have been the first one they did there. I'm not sure. I believe. So this was Magic Kingdom, but I believe at that same time they did a Frozen version of like Mad Tea Party at Hollywood Studios. Because I remember my niece just started doing the college program there, and that was one of her favorite things. And I think that's when they also did the. What was it? I think that where they used to have the Jack Sparrow experience, and they had like the Narnia experience at Hollywood Studios. Oh, yeah, that cool. They had this like small little Narnia thing during Prince.
Oh, was Cat. That in the One Man Presents?
I think so, or next to okay. it. Yeah. Because they had a thing where it was frozen. Then it said this way to the sauna. And it was basically you open the doors and you're outside in the Florida humidity.
So funny.
Yeah. That's all I got for this day in Disney history. So we do got some fun topics.
I will say that like May 25th is usually the kickoff to summer. They used to have big summer programs like Summer of Heroes, like Summer Rock, Rock Your Disney Side, like all these kind of things. So yeah, we're headed into summer.
Yeah, as of we're recording, we are pre Memorial Day weekend. So yeah, it's a good time for it, I guess. But we do have some fun topics coming up at throughout the Disneyland Disney World Resort. Who would like to go first?
Let's have Kelly go first since her thing starts this Friday.
Oh, perfect. So what do you got, Kelly?
Well, I'm talking about Fantasmic coming back
finally
to Disneyland Resort. And
if you didn't know, our Fantasmic has been gone for 13 months. So almost a year and a month because in last April is when Murphy burned itself to a crisp. So, which is the dragon. So yes, we're all
the dragon burned, and we were actually there that day. But
no, the day before we were there. No, the day after.
We were there that day.
But we didn't go in the resort.
Yes. No, we did not go in the park. We were at Downtown Disney. We were eating dinner with our friend for her birthday, and we got back to the hotel, and I think we were hearing about Murphy catching on fire, which was so weird and
crazy.
When we went to the park the next day, there was tarp everywhere.
You could still smell it in the air.
And you could still see the burn marks on Tom Sawyer Island or Pirate.
Wow, crazy.
Yeah, it was insane. So Fantasmic had to go down because they had to figure out what we were going to do. Our finale was pretty much gone, and I don't think they knew how to bring it back. He was not fixable. He burned. So Fantasmic is coming back this Friday, and woo-hoo, with it comes Fantasmic dining packages, and they've got some new packages and new features of the package. Normally there would just be one package at a restaurant or two restaurants, and that would be it. But this time they're bringing four different packages.
Nice.
Yeah, so there's going to be a package at Blue Bayou. There's going to be two different packages at Riverbell Terrace. Actually, three different packages at Riverbell Terrace. And there will be a package at Rancho del Zocalo, which they usually do Plaza Inn. But this is the first time they're doing a dining package at Rancho del Zocalo.
That's cool.
Correct. They've also done it at Hungry Bear in the past, too.
Yes, but it's the first time they're doing it at Rancho. So at the Blue Bayou, they're calling it a premium package, and you're going to enjoy a four-course lunch or dinner, and you'll receive a voucher for the reserve viewing location for your choice of one of the two Fantasmic performances. And this is going to be like a surf and turf style. It is a prefix menu, so you do not get to choose anything off the menu. You just get to choose what's off of their menu. So it's surf and turf, Oscar-style filet mignon, blackened ribeye and bourbon shrimp gumbo, heirloom tomato and watermelon salad, and a strawberry and pistachio salad, and then you'll enjoy a dessert. Fantasmic-inspired.
Cute.
Yeah, guests will receive a souvenir item for non-alcoholic beverages, and a wine pairing is available for an additional charge. Pricing starts at $89 per guest, for lunch and $89 per guest for dinner, $35 for children.
Hmm. And so a normal meal at the I was going to say a normal a meal at Blue Bayou is what, about 56?
Yeah, I would say probably.
I mean, if you get the steak, the steak is the highest item on that menu, I think.
Yes, so, but there's also an upcharge for the steak.
Yeah.
So it's $10 upcharge for the filet mignon or the ribeye.
So that's a decent price for the VIP or the dinner dining for the seating.
Yeah. I mean, that's a pretty good dinner show option if you're celebrating an event or a birthday or just want to make sure you get a good meal and a fantastic Fantasmic seating. Then that's a good one. But you could go a other route and go for a premium package at River Barrel Terrace. This is a dinner package. And this includes seating on the outside of Riverbell Terrace during Fantasmic. So
you're not going to be really close. You're going to be further away.
You'll be seated at the outside seating of Riverbell Terrace.
Interesting.
During Fantasmic. So this is only a 3-course dinner. And you'll be enjoying the first performance of Fantasmic on the outdoor terrace. Their prefixed menu is a platter featuring fried chicken, brisket and pork, and pork belly burnt ends, a pot roast, and mashed potatoes. And dessert is included as well. This is $89 again for dinner and $45 for children. There is no upcharge for anything there.
I'll take all of that.
Yeah. But then you could also do the standard package at Riverbell Terrace, and you can either do brunch or you can do dinner. Both prefix menus. Brunch is a loaded house fries with egg, apple pie pancakes, Nashville hot chicken, and brisket mac and cheese sandwich. And for dinner, you can choose Nashville hot chicken, brisket mac and cheese sandwich, a pork chop, or a sustainable fish with dessert. This gets you a voucher to a separate viewing location. This is not on the outside terrace. Okay. This is in the viewing location.
How much is that one?
And this one is going to be $55 per adult and $30 per child for both brunch and dinner.
Not bad.
Again, that sounds all that sounds good too.
I could deal without the hot chicken, but okay. Spicy hot.
Oh yeah.
And you can also choose which time you want to go. You can go to the first performance or the second performance.
Oh, okay, that's cool.
Yeah. So then you're going to go over to Rancho del Zocalo. This is a standard package. So the brunch and dinner at Riverbell Terrace for the viewing is also considered a standard package. So there's two premium packages, two standard packages. And then you have Rancho del Zocalo is going to have a Mexican Korean fusion style cuisine. And this is a 3-course meal. And you can choose between a chili verde riblet, a sweet and spicy shrimp taco, potato tacos, which are plant-based, or sweet and savory carne asada.
Sounds good.
You're going to have each entree is served with radish slaw, cilantro lime rice, Korean potato salad, refried beans, and a cortadillo and a fountain beverage of choice. There is a kids menu at Rancho. You could get a kids riblet, a kids potato taco, or a kids mac and cheese. And the kids menu comes with cuties, a cortadillo, and a refreshing beverage choice. So no dessert at Rancho del Zocalo.
Shrimp taco and the carne asada taco both sound delicious.
It kind of sounds really good. Mexican Korean fusion. I don't know where that came from, but it sounds good.
Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah.
And there's lunch or dinner, and lunch is $35 per guest adult and $25 per child. And you can book all of this on the dining reservation app or website.
Man, that all sounds good.
I just looked it up on the Disneyland app, and it's all the way out to July 21st, and they still have Blue Bayou reservations available. So,
wow.
Yeah, so that's interesting because they've updated the app too, so that you can, it makes it finding like dining and dining packages really easy now.
That's right. Yeah, I remember you were mentioning that.
Yeah, because it'll have a separate area for Fantasmic package, and it'll tell you where you can select your restaurant, and then probably from there you can select a time.
Well, I like the options. I mean, I know you, Courtney, you mentioned that they've done Hungry Bear in the past, but I mean, the options of Riverbell, Blue Bayou, and Rancho is a good, you know, selection, good choice, you know, options, and of course the different tiers too. That all sounds really good.
Yeah, I'm super excited about the Riverbell Terrace, like, outdoor patio seating during Fantasmic. Yeah. I mean, like, so you are farther back, but you are also seated. So you actually have a seat for Fantasmic.
Yeah.
So that's kind of cool.
Especially, like, with the updated show, you know, sometimes you don't need to be right up there, but you still want to be around the vicinity. And sitting down is definitely a bonus, you know.
Yeah. Well, this kind of just reminds me of when we went to Walt Disney World and we were kind of looking at dessert packages, like dessert dining packages for the fireworks. And there was like so many options of dining packages for the fireworks. You could do a dessert party after, you could do a dessert party before, you could do a dessert party during.
And sit
at the Tomorrowland Terrace there. And like, you could also do a dessert party at the Contemporary. So giving us more options, giving us unique, more restaurants than Plaza Inn or Hungry Bear or just Blue Bayou. Like, usually it would just be Blue Bayou if it was Blue Bayou, because it's the premium restaurant that everybody wants to eat at.
And then, but also right now they're doing a Magic Happens dining package at Plaza Inn as well. So
yeah, and they're doing a dessert party for Pixar over at California Adventure. So there's lots of dining packages for everybody to choose from.
Yeah, definitely. And I love, because it's just showing you. I mean, we've been saying this over the last couple of years, but even more now, just how much of a food destination Disneyland has become. And not just DCA, because it kind of started with DCA. Of course, we had like Blue Bayou and Plaza Inn, but now anywhere you go at, you know, Disneyland Park, you could get a quality meal, high end or just, you know, counter service, but it's all delicious. Yeah.
We love Rancho. We love to eat there. And they recently changed Rancho's menu a little bit around. No longer offering rice and beans with everything and offering chips and salsa, I believe.
And also no longer offering the tostadas.
Yeah, that's a big loss there. But still pretty good food, and usually everybody can find something to eat. So really good food there. And again, the Mexican-Korean fusion sounds interesting. Those flavors I don't think I've had together, so that's good.
Yeah, and when I heard about that, I thought, how can you be a Mexican restaurant without rice and beans? But then it hit me, you're at Disneyland, those are very filling. Nobody wants a gut bomb.
Right. Yeah, they probably were tired of throwing away rice and beans.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, I always asked for no rice and just beans, and then I hate when they put lettuce on the plate. I don't need lettuce on my enchiladas. Yeah. but I think the good new flavors, the chefs at Disneyland are always trying new things. So I'm excited. Yeah. We need to pick one and go.
So which one sounds, which one would you guys want to try first? Like, you know, if you, you had a choice,
I
just
think,
like, you
Rancho
know
would be my,
yeah, I think Rancho
my first choice.
Yeah.
Just because the price point's there. Mm-hmm. And also the food is unique.
And it's still like, isn't Rancho and Plaza Inn like the only restaurants at Disneyland that have the refillable fountain drinks, or is it still just Plaza Inn?
No, Rancho still has them as far as I know. I haven't been in there in a while.
Which is a big, that's a big thing, especially if you're having like, I would
Pizza
choose Rancho.
Pizza Port has them too.
Oh, that's right. I would choose Rancho, but a close second would be Riverbell. The because I do that Nashville chicken sandwich with mac and cheese. Mm-hmm. Holy crap, that sounds delicious. So
what you're saying is we should book one for your birthday.
Well, you know, we don't. That's up to you. And before we kind of get to a little break, our first break, you guys are actually going very soon, right, to see Fantasmic or?
Probably not till the end of June.
Oh, okay.
End
well, that's
June,
still,
yeah, but yeah,
end of June.
That's only a few weeks away, so
it's a whole month away. I know.
But I'm super excited for this. Fantasmic starts 3 days from now on Friday. Disney actually put out a quick little video that I'm just going to show. I'm not sure if this is going to be on YouTube. I believe it is, but just in case, I will go to, I say good friend, but just somebody I follow, Scott Gustin, you know, the to-go guy.
Yes.
Anything.
He is Disney the main reporter that everybody goes to.
So there's a short video and just a few things I noticed, but there's not really any spoiler alerts, but there could be a little, I don't know. Here it is. That's new.
Mm. Looks like we're getting our old dragon back.
Maybe. Or it might be just a screen
replica.
So definitely some of the lasers and stuff look brighter.
Yeah.
But the thing I noticed was the pink elephants looked a little updated.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I was hoping they would put like kind of like show scenes that like they did over in Florida, like Elsa and Moana and all them. Not exact ones, but kind of like show scenes. They may be keeping it away from us right now. I don't know. But
yeah.
And it does. I mean, Maleficent always rose up before the dragon came out.
Yeah, so it looks like she's out there longer. But another thing I noticed right away was obviously the return of the Peter Pan scene.
Yeah.
Were the Lost Boys always on the pirate ship?
No, they weren't.
Why I'm like, how come there's furries down there? It's the Lost Boys.
I think I want to say it was just Wendy, John, and Michael. If that, maybe just Wendy.
I think just Wendy. Than the pirates.
Wendy for sure.
Yeah.
Maybe John and Michael. I don't remember.
Yeah.
But it was mostly pirates trying to get at Wendy.
I don't know. Just that little addition. And
but I do like the addition of the Lost Boys on there. Yeah.
So we'll see. We'll find out. So, but before we get to our next topic, let's hear from one of our awesome sponsors on where in the park we can find some stuff.
Where in the Park Seek and Find Image Scavenger Hunt games will have you exploring theme parks like never before. But this is not like your childhood scavenger hunts. There are no word-based lists of items to find or a binder of riddles, trivia, math, or counting. Our games contain cards with images of details that can be found throughout the park just by walking around. You can play on your own schedule, so you don't have to worry about long lines, height requirements, or health concerns. Need help finding an image? We've got you covered, with hints and answers on each card so you're never left wondering where in the park the image can be found. Use the Scan Before Playing card to reveal an alternate image if one of the cards in your pack is currently hidden or removed from the park. Order today to get game packs for your next visits to the Disneyland Resort and Walt Disney World theme parks. But the fun doesn't stop there. We also have games for Universal Studios in Hollywood and Florida, Knott's Berry Farm, Six Flags, SeaWorld, and more. Ready to experience your favorite theme parks in a whole new way? Go to www.whereinthepark.com/waltzaptpodcast to get 10% off your order. A portion of the sale will also go to support the Walt's Apartment Podcast. Want $10 off your order instead? Visit patreon.com/waltzaptpodcast to become a lamplighter. With so much more to discover, the only question is, do you know where in the park?
Yes, we do. We love them. They're awesome.
Yeah, we do.
You know, and they're busy in Houston unless they're back. So,
actually, I think they were in New York because they were seeing Stephen Colbert the other night. So,
oh, that's right. I can't keep up with their travels.
They've been traveling for all week long or 2 weeks long. I don't know what week we're on.
Yeah, we're going to call it Where in the Nation are Kevin and Amanda. But now check them out. The games, they're awesome. If you're a seasoned Disney park goers as we are, especially you two, it's a fun, you know, challenging even for the hardcore Disney parks fan and Universal and all that good stuff. So. Check them
really
out.
They get really close to details, and you're like, I have never even seen that. I don't even know.
Yeah, but we also have some new stuff coming out around the resort, and Courtney is going to tell us about that.
Yeah, so I was looking at, and thanks to Gothic Rosie, she's wonderful. Yes. She posted the other day about a speaker series at the Pixar Place Hotel. So it's a limited time speaker series that is open to guests of the hotel. So you have to be staying at a Disneyland hotel to sign up for one of these. You sign up with a cast member at the front desk. But I thought it was very interesting because I've never seen them do this before. Yeah. And because it's a new Pixar Place Hotel, they are going to start this weekend on Saturday, May 25th. With Peter Son, who is the writer and director of Elemental. So he's going to be talking about probably Elemental and some other things that he's done for the company. And then Marissa Horowitz is the lead editor for Inside Out 2, and she's going to be there on Thursday, June 20th. And then Roger Gold, the creative director of Theme Parks Pixar Animation Studios, so he's the creative director of when they collaborate with Pixar Studios. He's going to be speaking on July 13th. So I just thought that was interesting that they're starting to integrate, people from the studios and into the parks, or at least around the parks.
Yeah, that's
kind of reminds me of, Destination D. Because they have Destination D over the Contemporary Hotel, which is put on by D23, which is kind of different. But it just kind of reminds me of like having like a little panel and all that with the creators of all the movies.
Yeah, it looks like these are going to be complimentary to hotel guests. So,
and is there like a small convention center area at Pixar Hotel?
Not that I know of. I don't think there used to be when it was Paradise Pier, unless they built one on, but I don't think so. I don't know.
Unless,
we haven't been over there.
Yeah. I'm thinking, a good place to do it would be even outside around the pool area.
That's what I was thinking it was probably going to be, or in the lobby.
Yeah. But that's pretty cool. Some heavy hitters right away. I mean, Elemental is a phenomenal movie. And I'm sure Inside Out, I think
Inside Out 2 looks so good.
Yeah. And they're already projecting it to possibly be the pre-numbers from what I've seen have it projected to be so far the top grossing movie of the year so far, which is saying a lot because there's been some pretty heavy hitting movies recently, you know, from around the studio. So,
yeah,
that's pretty cool. Again, if you guys had a chance, you know, staying at the Disney Park hotel and which I guess Pixar creator would you like to see?
I would go see Peterson.
Cool.
Yeah, that's a good one. Elemental was really good. But my favorite Pixar movie ever is Inside Out. So I have to pick the Inside Out 2
and see what Marissa Horowitz. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's cool. I would probably, if they had a speaker series with Brad Bird, who did The Incredibles, I would definitely.
Maybe that could come.
Because,
if this thing works out. Possibly.
Yeah, because I'm also a big fan of The Iron Giant, which is not Disney, but it's a great, probably one of my favorite non-Disney animated movies. Plus, he did like Tomorrowland and Mission Impossible. Mm.
I was going to say, he's definitely done way more than just Pixar. So that would probably be really cool to hear from him.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
But that's awesome. Yeah, I hope they really stick with this because, yeah, this is really cool for them to do that. And not just guests at Pixar, but like all three. And, you know, we have so few resort hotels, you know, it's nice that they can.
I think you can be staying at any resort, right?
I think you could be staying in any of the three. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's what I'm saying. We got so few resorts. So it's cool that everybody's welcome to. Go there.
Yes,
absolutely.
And hopefully, and I think they will open it up to more people. Maybe charge if you're not staying on a resort property. Maybe make it complimentary to them.
And then, if this works out, then you can, invite Disney animation people as well. You know, do it at the Disneyland hotel.
I think those would sell out. Right.
Or not just regular, good neighbor people visiting, but, D23 gold member.
Exactly. Right?
Just saying, give us
right
more,
there.
Yeah.
Give us
or
perks.
DVC or DVC members or something like that.
Yeah.
No, they get too much already. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, right.
I'm just saying, they will probably get it first before D23 members.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. But I'm glad that they're acknowledging it's another perk for staying at the hotel.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So I think they could
rotate hotels, too. They could do them in the Disneyland hotel if it's the animation. Mm-hmm. They could do it with somebody in the Grand Californian. You know, they have lots of space.
Yeah. And I know there is a convention center at
Disneyland.
Yeah, no, at the Grand Californian.
Well, there's also one at the Disneyland. My company.
That's right.
Does a party there every year, so they have ballrooms at least.
And I did a Run Disney Expo once, and it was decent space.
And Dapper Day Expo's there too. So
there you go.
Right on. That's super cool. I'm really looking forward to seeing people's videos and photos of those when they come up. But yeah, that's awesome. I got something really fun to talk about, but before we get there, let's hear from our other sponsor.
Well, hello, and welcome to Let's Get to Know Our Sponsor. Getaway Today has been helping Disney vacation dreams come true since 1990. Whether you choose to visit the happiest place on Earth or travel to Orlando and beyond, they want to help you. Need to know the best hotel in the area? What theme park ticket should you buy? Have a last minute change? No worries. Their travel experts are always here to help. Want to book a cruise and don't know where to start? Hey, they can help with that too. They will help you find the perfect cruise for your vacation, whether it is your first time or you're a well-seasoned cruiser. When you book your cruise with one of the Getaway Today's experts, you will have a dedicated agent to help you every step of the way. They take care of the details so you can have the most fun. Getaway Today has Layway, Peace of Mind Travel, allowing you to cancel or make changes up to 72 hours in advance. You will always have the most up-to-date vacation information, both pre-arrival and upon your welcome. Getaway Today will guarantee the best prices with no hidden fees. And every time you book through Getaway Today, they will donate a portion back to a charitable organization in your area. And so far, over $4.5 million has been donated. So click the link in our show notes to start your Disney vacation planning for more information and the best deals. Tell them Walt's Apartment sent you. And until next time, enjoy the view from Walt's Apartment.
Boop. Yes, Getaway Today. They are awesome. They're a great group of travel agents that help you book your Disney trip, and not just Disney trip, but other places too. But yeah, check them out. As David, our Blurred Hulk friend, would say, get you some.
Get you some.
Get you some. But one thing that was announced, I think a couple weeks ago, and this was for Disney Springs, was they were going to do a drone show. And I'm like, well, that's pretty cool. You got all the water there. It's Disney Springs is huge. And I was actually kind of looking forward to this. So we were going to bring it up anyways. And but I just happened to get a message from my niece, who's a cast member there. And she actually took some photos and videos of it. And holy crap, this looks amazing. So yeah. Let me try to pull some of this up. But it is. See? Yeah. So it is called a Disney Dreams That Soar, and it looks like it's over the lake area of Disney Springs.
Oh, okay, cool. So
let me pull this
up. The only thing I would worry about is if one of the drones aren't working, then it falls in the lake. But yeah. Okay.
Well, make sure they float. So
yeah, maybe they won't. Oh, that looks
so cool. Some things are popping up on the interwebs right now. So those might be a little bit more clear, but you know, I'm glad my niece was there. Oh, that's the other thing. She was at Hollywood Studios on the day, 35th anniversary. She just got there, got their map, and they left. So
there wasn't much to do anyways.
Yeah.
It's Zero and Mary Poppins.
Yeah. So I got a little mixture of. Cute. Yeah. I got a mixture of photos and videos. So.
Okay.
So they're celebrating a cast life. So.
Awesome.
It's nice being a cast member.
Yeah, love cast members. Yeah, shout out to cast members.
Absolutely. And also shout out to my niece. The previous Monday, they did a yoga on Main Street at 5 a.m.
Wow.
And yeah.
Wow.
So apparently, and this was a cast member thing as well. So apparently they're filming for Yoga Day, International Yoga Day.
Ah, got it.
Good evening.
Can you guys hear it?
Right here.
Yeah.
Dreams That Soar.
Tinkerbell.
I know, I was going to say, it kind of just feels like Tinkerbell is in the sky.
Yeah.
Come on, everybody. Here we go.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
We need to go to Walt Disney World.
I love that they're classics.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Oh, like I keep manually doing the audio.
That's a space station.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, they were doing Star Wars too. Nice.
Oh, that's so cool.
I mean, you saw how cool it looked at the Angels game. Yeah.
Yeah. It looks like we're going through hyperspace.
No, they're doing a battle.
Okay, well, that's not what it looks like.
They blew up the Death Star.
That's nice.
Nice.
thoughts will be with you. Always. Always.
Hello, I am Baymax, your personal healthcare companion.
That's cool.
Baymax, wings.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
Fine, makes me a better healthcare companion.
He deflated.
So. Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah. The Milano.
That's rad.
Mixtape.
Guardians of the Galaxy. That's awesome.
Oh, yeah. Nice, Peter Quill. I am Groot.
To infinity and beyond.
That's cool.
Yay.
There's a place beyond the sky.
I'm guessing that's finale, so a little bit.
Where new beginnings never get old. You can like
magic carpet.
Peach dragon.
If
you're feeling small, you can fly away. A new
adventure is coming your way. And tomorrow's always brighter than yesterday.
Oh, it's Moon Girl.
Oh, is that who that? I was
trying
to figure out who that was.
Yeah, that's Moon Girl.
Yeah, it's Moon Girl, yeah.
Oh, the fairies.
Moon Girl and Dinosaur or something?
Yeah. Figment. Okay. Oh,
that looks
there's
cool.
No excuse.
I'm not
it needs
play the
to
whole
come
thing.
To Disneyland.
With Mando. Like,
yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
I like the song.
There's no excuse. There's
the
no
characters.
Excuse.
You know, when we first started seeing the drone shows in like Paris and stuff like that, I was so jealous. And
yeah.
I'm so glad Florida's got it, but they need to bring it to Disney.
Well, like I mentioned before, it makes sense for them to be at Disneyland since, you know, there's so many people that live in the neighborhoods around, you know, that they don't
the
want
noise pollution. The noise pollution.
But that
I
looks
mean,
awesome.
If we got that instead, like on weekdays instead of fireworks, I'd be okay with that.
Exactly.
Like, you know, like they don't always.
You could still have the fireworks on the weekends, but do the drones during the week.
It's definitely a good drones and projections, you know.
Heck yeah.
It's a good alternative, but
that
looks
like a very good, well thought out show. Like, seriously.
Yeah. And so
it's spot on.
Mm-hmm.
It sounded awesome. Yeah. I love how I love anytime you add the classic films because I feel like they get forgotten or they want to reboot them. So the fact that they're Peter Pan, Dumbo, but you still have Raya and Star Wars and Guardians.
Marvel.
So,
yeah.
But no, that looks awesome. Thank you, Tori, for sending that to
me. Yeah.
Yes,
Tori, that was
you.
Amazing.
Yeah. I cannot wait.
I've got to plan a trip to Walt Disney World now.
Yeah, no kidding. Bummer. but we're about to wrap up here, but we do have a few quick trips that I think it's just worth mentioning here. So I'll let you guys pick each one since I wrote in if you saw in the chat. So since Kelly went first with Fantasmic, I'll have you go first, Courtney, with the quick trips.
Annual pass holder previews for Tiana's is starting on June 13th. They're only on select days, though. And you do have to have a reservation. Now, don't quote me, but I did see that, like, they were all grabbing them even before the actual dates were announced. So, I don't know if there is any left or whatnot, but they are starting on June 13th, 14th, 16th, 17th, 18th, and the 20th. And then I believe it opens to the public on the 28th. So,
sweet.
And that's just annual pass holders. In between there, they are going to have a media preview. Obviously, they're going to have a DVC preview. They're going to have cast member previews. So that's why there's only on select dates.
As they're announcing these, we're actually getting water testing now at Disneyland.
Exactly. So
that's pretty cool.
Yeah. And also, you do have to have a virtual queue line. I don't know for the pass holder previews, but when it opens to the public, you can only ride it via virtual queue getting a individual lightning lane. Or
fancy. Not individual. No, it's not going to be a fancy ride.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
Where did That's you see that? Because I saw that it was.
Said it was. No, I saw that it was just going to be in Genie Plus.
Okay, cool.
Well, we'll find out.
Yeah.
We're around the corner, so right on.
Yeah.
We'll see how that comes about on June 28th, because I heard it was going to be a fancy ride. So
maybe they decided that now. I don't know. I think it was like a week ago. I saw that it, because there wasn't a price. They said it was just going to be in just Genie Plus, but maybe they changed their mind.
That has happened.
Yes. Yeah. Anything is possible. But yeah, that's my little quick bite.
What else do we have, Kelly?
Well, there is a rumor or a maybe an announcement of a Club 33 film. I haven't seen anything official announced, so I'm not sure. But I think that would be kind of weird to have a Club 33 film because it's so closed off to the public that you're not supposed to know anything about Club 33.
Yeah, it's kind of a if you know, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's supposed to be a view a know, you know type of thing. So I'm not sure how I feel about the Club 33 film. How do you feel?
Well, I think with the it's now, you know, with social media and the internet, like even the people that don't know, they're like, oh, yeah. I read about Club 33, you know, so I think it is in the know. And maybe this is the way they're like, well, obviously not everybody could get in, but hey, you go give us money and watch a movie about it.
Yeah.
So according, and this is from the DisInsider, so it is at rumor stage right now.
Yeah.
But it says Darren Lemke is set to write the script. So I'm not too familiar. Okay. Darren Lemke, who I guess penned Goosebumps. I don't know if it's a show.
It's a show. That was a show on Hulu and Disney Plus, and actually I watched it. It was very good. They adapted the stories of R.L. Stein very well. So,
and so what's written here, it says Darren Lemke, who penned the script for Goosebumps, and it will exude the tones and vibes of Clue and Night at the Museum.
Which I could see that kind of being interesting if they stick with like the Clue kind of thing, like, hey, you're all invited to a dinner party at Club 33 and something goes down, you know what I mean? But that it's not all about,
yeah,
I don't know, because I don't want to really give Club 33 like a fake backstory, because like that we all know the backstory of Club 33. It was a space that Walt wanted to entertain his high-end. Like, yeah, that's exactly what it was.
And we all saw how rewriting the Haunted Mansion's backstory went with the first movie and kind of the second movie. So I don't know about
that. And I know for years, like, Disney's been wanting to do a movie style of, like, Night at the Museum. Years ago, like, what long before even The Jungle Book, Jon Favreau was actually working on a script called Magic Kingdom. And it was very similar to like a Disney version of Night at the Museum, not really going into the tones of like Kingdom Keepers, but still.
I was just going to say that sounds like Kingdom Keepers.
Yeah.
I think they should do a Kingdom Keepers movie.
I think so, too. I think it was very adaptable. Like,
that's what they should be doing. I don't know if we need this Club 33 movie, but we should be doing a Kingdom Keepers movie because
kids loved those books.
Adults loved them too.
I mean, they're still in there. Like, they still sell the copies in the parks. So, like, it's just a matter of recreating the parks, but they've already done that for, like, Saving Mr. Banks.
Yeah.
Or, you know, filming in the parks, you know.
And so when they're talking about the Magic Kingdom movie, there was also the time where it was Guillermo del Toro was heavily working on pre-production of his Haunted Mansion movie. And there was talks that he donated some of his stuff to Jon Favreau for reference, and that they might have tied in together.
Okay.
But I mean, that's years ago. And then Kingdom Keepers.
Never see it.
Yeah. But Kingdom Keepers was actually one of the rumored shows that was supposed to premiere when Disney Plus premiered. And
I think it would be too expensive for a show, but I do think the stories lend well to a series format, but I think you could do it as a movie.
Yeah, but it was.
And I also think they could tie in a Club 33 movie into that because they'd be running Disneyland.
Because it was supposed to be a show, and it was being show run by Kevin Smith. But the guy that was in charge of programming axed it for The Mandalorian. So Kevin Smith was like, yeah, you guys didn't get my piece of crap show, but you guys got The Mandalorian. I'm good with that.
Why
can't we have both?
I know.
We could now.
We have so much Star Wars and Marvel.
Yeah. What's The Mandalorian, though?
Let's do some Kingdom Keepers.
I'd rather have Mandalorian than Kingdom Keepers.
Mandalorian. I love Mandalorian. I watch Mandalorian. But let's get some Disneyland content.
Exactly. Well, we can now.
Yeah.
But last quick trip, we're starting to get some new footage and pictures, just little stuff, but of Country Bears that's going to be opening, I think, later on this summer. What are the names? I always remember the Beulah.
yes, the Sunny, Benny, and Beulah.
Yeah.
I think. The three little triplets, yes.
Yeah. And they got a little bit of a facelift. Not too much, which I like, but they got a little brightened up. They look a little bit more modern. So I'm excited. I love Country Bears, the attraction, not the movie. I'm glad that it looks like all our characters will be getting a little updated look.
Well, yes, because
they look traditional.
Because the songs that they're singing, they're Disney songs, but they're reimagined into like rockabilly and
bluegrass.
Like they're going to be different takes on them. So their costumes are reflecting that. So,
yeah, I'm excited. I mean, you sent that to me and I was like, oh my gosh, that looks awesome.
Yeah.
Well, right on. So that is it for our episode. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Hope you guys enjoyed the exclusive footage that we had from the drone show. So I know
that
I did.
Was so amazing. So make sure you watch the YouTube version of this so that you can see how good these drones actually look in person.
Yeah, absolutely.
And the Country Bears trio is Bunny, Bubbles.
Okay.
That's right.
So not Bunny, but Bubbles.
Right.
No, there's Bunny. There's no Sunny. Bunny, Bubbles, and Beulah. They all start with B.
They're all B nails. Okay, got it.
That makes sense.
They are the Sunbonnet Trio. That's what they're called.
Yeah.
Okay.
I just loved them from the Vacation Hoedown when they're singing California Bears.
Oh, I like their song with like all the guys that like me turn me down.
That's a fun one.
all the guys I like turn me down. That's what
it's right on. No, I think it's all the guys that turn me on turn me down.
That is what it is.
Classic. Well, thank you, ladies, for joining. Always love Extra Magic Hour with you guys. So
Sam
will be with us next week, and Big Papa Disney too, hopefully. So we'll see. But we will see you guys in 2 weeks with another Extra Magic Hour. So until next time, we'll see you at the parks.
Yeah.
Bye. Yay.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land. Here age relives fond memories of the past, and here youth may savor the challenge and promise of the future. Disneyland is dedicated to the ideals, the dreams, and the hard facts that have created America, with the hope that it will be a source of joy and inspiration to all the world. Thank you.